Welcome back. Behind me, you're looking at a beautiful painting, a painting that sells for thousands of dollars. Okay, you say, so what? Well, this is what. This magnificent work of art was painted by a spiritual young lady who was all of 11 years old. She's Akiane Kramerik, and she's been painting from the age of 4. To say that this Post Falls, Idaho native is an extraordinary talent would be a gross understatement. Now come with us as we meet this young genius with such an amazing gift and learn how she does it and how she changes the lives of all who have come in contact with her.
One day I had a dream of meeting God, but I was not quite sure. I had never met God and never been told about God.
It was very confusing because at that time I was an atheist. But her talk was intelligent. Every time she would talk about God and the details of her life in heaven, how she described it, it was very, very sophisticated. And I knew that at that time, nobody else could have influenced her in that way because we led a closed life.
As time went on, we paid more attention to it, and then it developed into painting and then poetry.
The angel has like faith and hope still, and they have power from God. They're angels, they're guardians for us. I wanted to show how the angels protect us, how angels just show us where to lead, show us where to go in even difficult paths. When I started doing all these details, it's like, well, how did that happen? How did God give me these ideas? And He gives me those ideas through my visions and dreams at night, or when I'm walking, when I'm reading, or anything I do. So when I started having those, I said, I need to do something. I have a mission to complete in life. I wanted to express the beauty and the suffering of the black race. When I was painting her eyes, you could see her whole life in her eyes. You could see how much she provided in her family and how she believed in God with hope. And I painted Jesus when He's in the Garden of Gethsemane, and He's raising the world to His Father and saying, forgive them. And I wanted to paint Him because he's everything that I am. He's everything that I want to be and everything that I will be.
She would talk about the future events that God shared with her. And I would write everything down in a diary. A lot of times, most of the times, I would say 95% of the time, she said, I was taken, I was shown, but you're forbidden to know. When a time will come, you will know. And there was nothing I could do to extract the information, which was very frustrating for me.
You know, I look around and I'm amazed because I know how much work's involved. I know how much she works. I'm with her all the time where she works. And I get goosebumps a lot of times and say, no, what are we doing today? You know, you know, what's going on today? So it's, yeah, I'm excited, flabbergasted, and just amazed a lot of times.
I saw this in my dream. I saw that, and I felt that it was in real life, that see-through world, and I saw that. I saw many other things, many other planets, and this is the most beautiful spot I ever saw, and this, I wanted to put Him instead of me in the background into this picture. When I'm frustrated, I need to like pray for a little bit and says I need to go back on track. I need God's help to help me to fix this mistake. Then He tells me, and then I start doing it, and I feel okay again. He gave me this scroll of poems, and I read it. I remember it even this day, and what I remember, it's in my poetry. And when I write effortlessly. I write without thinking. You need to cleanse and silent your eyes, for dizzy prayer bounces off a wall. All of your smile lands on silent swan. We need your love to catch you when you fall. Brassy visions count each and every stone. There are so many lives in this lonely womb. When feelings are hungry, mirrors show different faces. The only evening the swan lands, she looks for you.
Some people need church to know where they're going. And for us, we like to like go wherever we can in quiet and pray for a little bit. I keep doing that each day even, and I like it. And everywhere we go, even when I'm driving, or I'm on television or in interviews, I start praying and I say, please give me these words to tell other people what you have done to me, what I have experienced. And I said thank you, and then he helps me. And it's very good, and very good feeling.
Just imagine what Akiyana will be painting when she's 12.